a name called the file name, which is useful to identify a particular file. You will notice that every file has two parts, primary name, secondary name. Primary name, it is the first name or file name of a file. It can be any name given by the user. It should be meaningful. It can be a group of any characters and symbols. For example, XYZ, XY12, 12XT, etc. Secondary name, it is the extension of the file like .docs, .jpg, etc. It is given by the program where it is created. See the figure given alongside. It is an icon of a MS Word file. Here, birthday invitation is the file name or first name or the primary name, and .docs is the secondary name or extension of the file. Folder. A folder is a place where a collection of files or data are stored. In other words, files are placed inside a folder. A folder is also known as a directory. A collection of related files can be stored in a common folder. A folder may also contain different subfolders. A folder within a folder is called a subfolder with files in them. Each file in a folder has a unique name of the same program. See the figure. It is the icon of a folder. Before you start to learn about creating and managing, delete, copy and move the files and folders, let's learn about the system where files and folders are created and accessed. Computer window. Whatever files or folders you stored in your computer, they are accessible from the computer window. It is also used to access and manage the files and folders stored in various external memory devices. For example, CD, DVD, pen drive, etc. The steps to open the computer window are: click on the Start button, then Computer, or double-click on the computer icon on the desktop. Shortcut. To open the computer window, Windows plus E. The computer window will look as given below. Left or navigation pane. It is located on the left side of the computer window. Here, memory drives and directory tree can be seen. It contains the list of memory drives, hard disk, DVD drive, folders and subfolders that you have on the computer. It does not show or lists the files. Right side. It is located on the right side of the window and it shows the content of the folder, which is selected at the left side. Both the files and folders are shown here. Creating a new folder. A folder can be created in a drive, folder, or on the desktop. You can use the context menu using right-click, toolbar, or shortcut keys to create a new folder. Now let us learn about these methods. Context menu using a right-click. This method can be used to create a new folder using the right-click of the mouse. The steps to create a new folder are: open the computer window, open the location or drive or folder where you want to create a folder. Right click on the blank area, the context menu appears. Select the new option, a submenu appears. Click on the folder option, a new folder is created and appears. Type a name for the folder and press the enter key. A new folder is created using the toolbar. This method can be used to create a new folder using the new folder button given on the toolbar. The steps to create a new folder are: on the computer window, open the location where you want to create a new folder. Click on the new folder button on the toolbar. A new folder is created. Type a name for the folder and press the enter key using the shortcut keys. We can create a new folder using the shortcut keys also by following the steps given below. Open the drive or folder in the computer window or on the desktop. Press Ctrl plus Shift plus N. Renaming a file or folder. To rename means to change the name of an existing file or folder. The steps to rename a file or folder are Method 1. Select the file or folder that has to be renamed. Right-click on it. A context menu appears. Select the Rename option. Type the new name and press the Enter key. Method 1. Select the file or folder that has to be renamed. Press the F2 function key located above the number keys. Type the new name and press the Enter key. Method 3. Open the computer window and locate the file or folder. Select the file or folder that has to be renamed. Click on the Organize on the toolbar. A drop-down menu appears. Select the Rename option. Type the new name and press the Enter key. Selecting files and folders. Files or folders can be selected in different ways. Let us see these methods. To select a file or folder, click on it. To select adjacent or continuous files or folders, click on the first file or folder to be selected. Then hold down the Shift key and click on the last file or folder to be selected. To select non-adjacent or randomly located file or folders, click on the first file or folder to be selected. Then hold down the Ctrl key and click on the files or folders to be selected. Deleting a file or folder. An existing file or folder can be deleted too. The steps to delete a file or folder are: select the file or folder that has to be deleted. Right-click on the required file or folder. A context menu appears. Select the Delete option. Or press the Delete key on the keyboard. The operating system Windows confirms before deleting the file or folder by displaying a dialog box. Note, when you delete a file or folder, Windows moves it to the recycle bin by default. The Delete Folder dialog box appears. Click on the Yes button to delete or No to cancel deleting. Shortcut. To delete a file or folder permanently, Shift plus Delete. Restoring the deleted file or folder. Files or folders that have been deleted by mistake can be restored from the recycle bin. The steps to restore the files or folders are: open the recycle bin window by double-clicking on the recycle bin icon on the desktop. It displays the list of deleted files and folders. Select the file or folder that has to be restored. Click on the Restore This Item button on the toolbar. The selected file or folder moves back to the place from where it was deleted. Copying a file or folder. Copying a file or folder means making a copy of the original file either in the same location or at another location, drive, without removing it from its original location. The steps to copy a file or folder are: open the computer window and select the file or folder that has to be copied. Click on the Organize List box on the toolbar and select the Copy option. Or right-click on the file or folder and select the Copy option from the context menu. Select the destination, drive or folder from the left or navigation pane. Click on the Organize List box on the toolbar and select the Paste option.